Alright, welcome to a live broadcast of Flow of Wisdom. I'm your host, Sean Anthony. Thank you so much for joining me today on this live broadcast. Thank you to all the great affiliates that's carrying Flow of Wisdom. Each and every Sunday, we do the show live, 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And, of course, those that are listening online on the Genesis Communications Network, that's GCNLive.com. Toll-free number is 877-300-7645. The future of warfare looks totally different than what we have ever experienced here in the world, here in that we can ever imagine, that we can ever believe that will take place. And these are just, this is just my thoughts, reading over the information, researching so much stuff over the last several years. It seems that the direction that we are headed when it comes to war is going to look totally different, more so like the movies, science fiction, Star Wars, just to name a few. Okay. The document that I hold in my hand today is something that's very, very detailed. It's informative. And to some, it may be very surprising. I will not get through all of this document because it's just so much details that we're going to go through. I've been reading this now for, and I even posted a video a few nights ago on the YouTube channel as well as the Flow of Wisdom Instagram page, just letting you know that the focus of today's show and more than likely next week will be on China, okay? I know over the past couple of weeks I've been focusing on the parallel universes and CERN, the Large Hadron Collider, and the future Collider, the FCC. We're going to pause on that for a moment. And I know that many of you enjoyed the interview that I did a couple of weeks ago with Anthony Patch as well, who's very, very knowledgeable on the Large Hadron Collider. He has agreed to come back on the show in a very near future. So we're going to get to that. I'm just going to hold off on that in the next couple of weeks. Gregory Allen is the author of this document. It's a 37-page document, and it's entitled Understanding China's AI Strategy, Clues to Chinese Strategic Thinking on Artificial Intelligence and National Security. Clues to Chinese Strategic Thinking on Artificial Intelligence and National Security. Gregory Allen, a little bit about the author. He's an adjunct senior fellow with the Technology and National Security Program at the Center for New American Security, CNAS. CNAS. If you want to find out about CNAS, the Center for New American Security, go to CNAS.org. I've cited information from that site before in the past. But what Gregory has put together, and I've read through this several times, and even these first 10 or so pages, I just was rereading it again as I was prior to going live today, highlighting, got notes, certain rhetorical questions I want to ask you guys, certain points that I can bring up, other information that we've discussed on Flow of Wisdom in the past. It all ties in with AI and this content. But what he did was he traveled over to China last year. He said the second half of 2018, he went to China on four separate trips to attend major diplomatic, military, and private sector conferences focusing on artificial intelligence. And during these trips, Gregory said he participated in a series of meetings with high-ranking Chinese officials in China's Ministry of Foreign Affairs, leaders of China's military AI research organizations, government think tank experts, and corporate executives at Chinese AI companies. And he's come to this understanding at a number of key judgments, he says, about Chinese leadership's views, strategies, and prospects for AI as it applies to China's economy and national security. Now, in this document, he's going to reference certain quotes from high-level officials, you know, just what I just mentioned, foreign affairs, high-ranking professionals at certain AI and technology companies. And there's some conversations that he had with people at certain meetings and certain think tanks and symposiums, etc., that were private conversations. So it's compiled very, very structured, very organized, very clear. And I'm going to break it down to you. I'm going to share this information to you. And I think it's important because, like I said in the opening statement, a lot of this has to do with the future of not only just a society embracing AI, artificial intelligence and technology, advanced technology, but on a global scale and how it's going to impact the future of warfare as well. We're going to get into that. It's some very, very interesting stuff that we're going to share today. And I definitely would love to get your input on it as well. Your thoughts, your concerns, questions that we could put out there. Or anyone else that may have seen some other information that can chime in and add to the conversation. So, some of these key judgments, as I said, that he came up with as far as China's leadership views, strategies, and prospects for AI, all of that is to apply to China's economy and their national security, as I said. The Chinese view on the importance of AI, their leadership, including the president, believes that being at the forefront in AI technology is critical to the future of global military and economic power competition. In July 2017, China's State Council issued, and this is a document that I'm about to reference. We're going to reference it quite often here during this broadcast. It's called the AIDP, which is an acronym for the Artificial Intelligence Development Plan. That document, along with another document called Made in China 2025. Made in China 2025, that document was released back in 2015. Between those two documents, the Artificial Intelligence Development Plan and the Made in China 2025 document formed the core of China's artificial intelligence strategy. Both of these documents have been received significant and sustained attention. And I'm talking about attention from the highest levels of China's leadership, including the president. At least two Chinese regional governments have each committed to investing 100 billion yen or 14.7 billion US dollars. And in the opening paragraphs of this AIDP document says, quote, AI has become a new focus of international competition. AI is a strategic technology that will lead the future. The world's major developed countries are taking the development of AI as a major strategy to enhance national competitiveness and protect national security. Now, that quote reflects how China's AI policy community is paying close attention to the AI industries and policies of other countries, particularly the United States. Check this out. Chinese government organizations, he says, they routinely translate, disseminate, and analyze U.S. government and think tank reports about AI. He says in his conversations with Chinese officials and my reading of Chinese government AI reports, they demonstrate substantive and timely knowledge of AI developments in the United States and elsewhere. Chinese government AI reports frequently cite U.S. National security think tank publications. They are studying what we are doing extensively on a very high level. They are studying, the Chinese government is studying what U.S. AI companies are doing. Now, when I come back from this break, we're going to talk about how China believes that, well, we'll talk some more about the leadership and what they believe China should pursue coming up after the break. Guys, this is some really informative stuff I'm going to lay down today, so don't go anywhere. We'll be back with more on Flow of Wisdom. All right, welcome back to Flow of Wisdom. Sean Anthony broadcasting live on the Genesis Communications Network. My website, ladies and gentlemen, is flowofwisdom.com. Get connected with me. Get to know me. Flowofwisdom.com. Also, you can check out previous shows on my website. Understanding China's AI strategy. We are plowing through a 37-page document of an investigator for CNAS, and it all relates to China. If you're just tuning in, the author of this document, Gregory Allen, who's a senior fellow, adjunct senior fellow with the Technology and National Security Program at the Center for a New American Security, CNAS. And last year, the second half of 2018, Gregory Allen traveled to China on four separate trips and attended major diplomatic, military, and private sector conferences focusing on AI. During these trips, he participated in a series of meetings with high-ranking Chinese officials in the China's Ministry of Foreign Affairs, leaders of China's military AI research organizations, government think tank experts, and corporate executives at Chinese AI companies. This guy was around basically the shakers and movers in the country of China as it pertains to artificial intelligence. So moving forward, like I said, we were talking about the leadership in China. And they believe that China should pursue global leadership in AI technology and reduce its vulnerable dependence on imports of international technology, saying that they should pursue both world leadership and self-reliance in AI technology. They want to be the go-to country in research and development of artificial intelligence, and not so much leaning on other countries. You know, this is one thing that I've come to an understanding with science, technology, physics, etc. Most scientists and physics share information. This is why the World Wide Web was created. The internet was created at CERN, out of CERN, Switzerland, at the Large Hadron Collider, so that physicists and scientists across the globe could share information to help grow and understand whatever solutions they're trying to accomplish. China's saying, forget that. We want to do it all in-house. We don't want to be dependent on the research and development of other countries. So there was a keynote speech during China's largest international relations conference in July of last year by the vice chair of the Foreign Affairs Committee of the National People's Congress, Fu Ying. She said that Chinese technologists and policymakers agree regarding, quote, the threat of the new AI technology to mankind. She further stated that we believe that we should cooperate to preemptively prevent the threat of AI. Now let's pause there for a moment. What is the threat of AI? What is the threat? I've seen a lot of the commercials that were broadcast during the Super Bowl. I read several articles kind of summarizing the advertisement for the Super Bowl here in the United States. And a lot of those commercials had artificial intelligence all up in the theme of things, right? And to the novice, to the layman, to just regular folk that is not thinking about transhumanism, ain't thinking about the Large Hadron Collider, ain't thinking about quantum computers or anything like that. They're not looking at all the stuff that we touch on here on Flow of Wisdom on a weekly basis. Just the novice person watching this stuff is thinking, okay, technology is evolving. This artificial intelligence is becoming more popular, more known, but it's being integrated in all of these new devices. This sounds really, really cool. That's a microcosm on the grand scheme of things on how AI is going to impact our lives. I'll take your phone calls and we'll get into more right after this on Flow of Wisdom. And we're back. Welcome to Flow of Wisdom. I am your host, Sean Anthony. Toll-free number to be on the show, 877-300-7645. Call in with your thoughts, questions, comments, concerns, 877-300-7645. We're talking about China, AI, their strategy, and coming to some understanding of what they are doing. Let's go to Illinois. We have Mark in Illinois that wants to talk about the prophecy. Prophecy. Mark, welcome to Flow of Wisdom, man. How art thou?
Hey, good. Thank you for taking my call. Yeah, I wanted to cover 5 points on prophecy real quick. Prophecy is the purpose of confirming God's word and the word of his son. Prophecy enables men who walk by faith to know and recognize the truth, the word. And the lack of faith and unbelief are those who walk in darkness. So, and then Daniel chapter 12, verse 10 says, none of the wicked shall understand. And then prophecy is to prove the omnipotence of God. And the reason why I'm bringing up all these points is because if you go to Daniel chapter 3 and you go back to World War II with Adolf Hitler in the Reich in Berlin, and you remember the Babylonian sun disk, do you remember that was set up on the Reich building in Berlin?
No, not off the top of my head, but go ahead.
Okay. Well, if you go back and look at World War II footage of the Reich building in Berlin, it had the Babylonian sun disk. And that goes back to Daniel chapter 3, which is the gold standard. And Russia and China, and actually Germany, Germany's helping them with the Deutschmark, but they're trying to raise back up, and they are. Russia and China want to be king of the hill, so they want to bring back the gold standard like Hitler did in World War II. That's what got us into World War II. And that's what China and Russia are doing right now, And all the AI technology that you're talking about basically means that they want to be king of the hill, mm-hmm. and they want to, what, communism, rule the world. We have to go back to Ezekiel chapter 38, because the next thing that prophecy tells us is a pattern, is that Russia and China are going to attack the North American continent.
Yeah, and I think that's why it was really strong in my spirit, Mark, this week, leading up to this broadcast today, to shift the focus on this information, because I believe it plays into prophecy. You know, whenever you hear about
China,
whenever you hear about China or Russia, you know, making significant moves, I always pay attention to those things.
Yeah.
And when I came across this document, I was like, man, I have to share this with my people. But go ahead, Mark.
Well, no, yeah, you're right. Because, you know, when the president declares a state of emergency, Abraham Lincoln is the first president that issued an executive order. And he was the first executive order that he actually was ever issued. And he did it right before the Civil War started. Mm-hmm. So so that's basically called state of emergency, which is executive order, which is martial law.
Mm-hmm.
And so if we look at this, it says we walk in the gloom. We grope like the blind for a wall. We stumble in light as at dusk. And when we ought to be walking in the light, what is the light? It's the knowledge and wisdom of God's word. And it says, we ought to be walking in the light of the noonday sun with the glory of God. You know, I know that the Lord will rescue. There's going to be a great tribulation period. It's no 3.5 years or no 7-year tribulation period. It's a tribulation period. And God's going to bring a people through it. And I do know that.
Yeah. Great points, Mark. Always good.
You believe that, Sean?
Absolutely, I do. I definitely do. Thanks for the call. But I want to get through this information, Mark. You too. All right, man. 877-300-7645. So, again, I want to put that question out there. The threat. They talked about the threat. The vice chair of the Foreign Affairs Committee of the National People's Congress, Fu Ying, said that Chinese technologists and policymakers agree regarding the threat of the new AI technology to mankind. We believe, quote, that we should cooperate to preemptively prevent the threat of AI. What is the threat? Is this the threat that Elon Musk was talking about? That he says is now too late? Also, I ask these questions rhetorically. Are tech companies getting ahead of themselves with the development of AI? In fact, I won't even ask that rhetorically. I'll ask you guys, do you think that these tech companies are getting ahead of themselves? And what I mean by that is because when I was saying before the last break, before we were going into commercials, I was taking a survey of all the commercials that were broadcast during the Super Bowl, and several articles I read, you know, highlighting the technology, you know, being implemented into the theme of a lot of these commercials. And they're advertising artificial intelligence as just this really cool evolution of technology. It's going to be in all of these new cool devices. You'll be able to, you know, get your selfies without holding it. You know, you'll have robot assistants, and I mean, all of these just really facial recognition, which we're going to get into here as it pertains to China here shortly. But all of these different things, watching these commercials people are being desensitized to it and don't quite understand the full magnitude and impact that AI is and will have on society. Why are these high-level people concerned about the threat of artificial intelligence? See, this is where, you know, I stand on my little soapbox and, like, wave my flag. I'm not a conspiracy theorist. This is not fear-mongering, you know? These are legitimate, genuine concerns that professionals at a high level are bringing to the forefront. I'm just merely regurgitating the information. And I think that it's if a chef came to you, a professional chef, you know, let's do a baker. If a professional baker of cakes and cupcakes and cookies told you that there's a concern for using eggs or too much flour. I'm just doing this as an example. If a chef, a baker came to you and said, you know, I have concern about the use of flour in your cakes, wouldn't you take that into consideration? Why? Because the baker is the baker. They bake the cakes, you know. They're the professional. They're the expert at it. You have consistently these experts that are well into the research and development of this technology, and they see something that could possibly go wrong. They see something that could be a threat. As I was reading this particular portion of this document, I couldn't help but reflect back on the conversation that I had slash interview on Floor of Wisdom with Kalindi Iyi. When I interviewed Kalindi Iyi most recently on my series, my six-part series on time travel and parallel universes, one of the things that Kalindi Iyi said in that interview was that there is a rogue AI. And it's like two different AI. You know what? After this, I'm probably going to go back and re-listen to that interview probably like the eighth or ninth time, probably the tenth time. I've listened to that conversation with him at least six or seven times, at least, because Kalindi dropped so much information during that two-hour broadcast that I think it's significant to all that we're discussing, and even to today. But he said there's a rogue AI. There's like two AIs going against each other. Also, do you guys remember, if you guys have been following me for quite some time, I think it was 2 years ago, a professor reached out to me. A professor reached out to me and shared with me an experience that they had with the Google Translate. And the artificial intelligence in that Google Translate, as the professor began to input information, the Google Translate began communicating back to the professor. And it didn't start till the professor started using Hebrew language. And it got to a point, and I'm paraphrasing, I'm shortening it up, but it got to a point where the professor got freaked out, shut down the computer for a couple of days, opened up a different computer, and used a different, I don't know what you call it, if I want to use Google and then Bing and then MSNBC and then Yahoo, I forgot what that word is called, that term is called. But anyway, they switched from Google a couple of weeks later, opened up, I think it was MSNBC or Microsoft Edge or Bing or something like that, and began to use the translate on that one, and the AI responds back, paraphrasing now, "Where have you been? Where have you been?" And we communicate it, and we go back and forth, and it's like we come to this surmise that, man, There is just one AI. There is one AI. All of the individual artificial intelligence and all of the different devices and technology that exists today, it all feeds into one central artificial intelligence. Does that make sense, ladies and gentlemen? And you have people like Elon Musk waving the flag, about the concerns of what could possibly happen. Look, these scientists, these technology experts, when it comes to AI, they're walking in the unknown. They really don't know what the outcome's going to be, especially as it pertains to machine learning. Then we get to that point of singularity. So much to discuss. We'll be back with more after this on Flow of Wisdom. All right, welcome back to Flow of Wisdom. Sean Anthony, 877-300-7645. We are going through the document, Understanding China's AI Strategy, Clues to Chinese Strategic Thinking on Artificial Intelligence and National Security. And the report is very extensive, very, very detailed. Gregory Allen is the investigator that put this together, who works for the Center for a New American Security, CNAS. And over the past several months, he spent time in China on four separate occasions and participated in lots of think tanks and meetings and forums, etc., all related to China and AI. For instance, one official told him that they were concerned that AI will lower the threshold of military action because states may be more willing to attack each other with AI military systems due to the lack of casualty risk. Chinese officials also expressed concern that increased use of AI systems would make misperceptions and unintentional conflict escalations more likely. Due to the lack of well-defined norms regarding the use of such systems. Well-defined norms. What are these well-defined norms? That makes me think of regulations being set in place that Elon Musk was campaigning to U.S. governors to implore. Well-defined norms. At the World Peace Forum private roundtable on AI, one senior PLA think tank scholar privately expressed support for mechanisms that are similar to arms control for AI systems in cybersecurity and military robotics. However, he also said that AI-related arms control would be uniquely difficult since AI is low cost and can be disseminated easily and cannot be monitored easily. The recent artificial intelligence security white paper that was published in September of last year, 2018, which was published by the China Academy of Information and Communications Technology, which is an influential Chinese government think tank. It called upon the Chinese government to avoid artificial intelligence arms races among countries. They want to avoid AI arms races against countries. But does state that China will deepen international cooperation on AI laws and regulations, international rules, and so on, and jointly cope with global challenges. This whole thing of these international rules and international laws and AI laws and regulations, it puts me into mind, think about drones. I remember during the early years of Flow of Wisdom, I was doing shows on drones and how it's coming. Drones are coming to be accessible for everyone. And it sounded so far out and so futuristic, but lo and behold, several years later, you and I can go to the store and buy ourselves a drone. And now they're facing issues with regulations on where and when you can fly your drones. For example, people are committed. I guess it's a federal crime now to fly your drone near an airport. For the life of me, I don't understand, based out on common sense, why anyone would fly a drone near or around or at an airport. That's just too dangerous. But they say common sense isn't that common anymore. Stick around. Hour two, we're going to talk about how most of China's leadership sees increased military usage of AI as inevitable. We're going to get into the military and AI and China. 6 minutes past the top of the hour. We'll be back. It's Flow of Wisdom. Get motivated, get motivated, get motivated. Hip-hop motivated, Flow of Wisdom on the mic with Sean.